Geeks Gone Wrong.
Said babe or Chase something.
I said what's up dog.
No you didn't.
I said what's up dog.
No you didn't. And I don't know what's up dog. Is that something new in the shop? What's up dog? Talking to me like I'm like I can hear in this ear. You know I'm deaf in this ear.
Or maybe what the fuck do you have that one on?
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, so say have you been beside somebody that lit up a cigarette, and for some reason, how they lit it or whatever, it smells just like weed. I don't know.
You know what? I've had that a couple of times. Sometimes when my girl, she smokes Black and Miles. Sometimes I get flashbacks. But I mean, we all go out for smoke breaks at work, and only one of us actually smokes.
Wow.
So I catch that from time to time. All right, we ready when you finish fucking eating.
It's set down.
Okay, Rashawn, are you ready?
I'm always ready. I'm a diva.
You know, I had somebody unfollow me on Facebook because I kept saying a diva is a female version of an asshole, of an asshole. And I got blocked on fucking Facebook because of that, because I dared to go after the queen.
That's... I've heard of dumb reasons to get blocked on Facebook. That's one of them.
I mean, my sister blocked me because I was talking shit about the Cowboys once.
You're just going to have to grow a thicker skin when it comes to the Cowboys. I mean, everybody knows that they're not, they ain't right, baby. You know,
they always straight until like end of December, January.
If you say so, boss.
They usually straight. They're not necessarily the best, but they usually straight until it gets to the end of the year, beginning of the year. Everything just kind of fall apart. They make it to the playoffs, and there's an early exit almost every time.
You know what's funny is that I really don't care about football. I'm only talking about it because you are.
I personally don't care about, like, watching football. I keep, of course, like anything else, I keep up with what's going on. But I haven't actually watched a football game in years.
Awkward confession, I'm a basketball coach, and I watched my first basketball game of the season, like, today.
I've been watching highlights. It looks – let's be honest, like, most of what's happening in the bubble looks like rec league ball.
It does.
It looks just like
– I was telling my homeboy – or was it – no, it was my homeboy, assistant coach, same thing. I was telling him that right now the NBA looks like when you get to the gym and they've already had all the good runs and they're on that very last run where everybody's walking down the court and somebody keeps trying to throw the ball off the backboard to himself and dunk it.
Yep.
That's what the NBA looks like right now.
Yep. Cause it's always that one try hard. Like when everybody tired as fuck, it's always that one dude that's just trying to get his dunk today.
It's like, but, nigga. I mean, when everybody else is tired, that's a chance for that one try hard to actually shine. Because all of a sudden, the full court defense they've been playing all day long that's only annoyed people now is effective. And everybody's like, man, he's got D. He's got D for days when really he didn't. Everybody else just tired and thinking about going to replace all of the protein they lost playing basketball. Hi, Chase. I'm Rashani. I'm a fucking asshole. Are we recording?
Well, I've started, but
cool. Let me
ask you. Wait. I need to ask you a question about this here rec league ball. I got a question, and this is a question that was posed in a Facebook group a long time ago.
Oh God.
Trapping in rec league ball.
Why? Why would you trap in rec league ball when everybody stands at the 3-point line? But at the same time, I also posit this. Taking your high school basketball team to play rec league basketball inside of a gym, like pickup basketball, and you have your whole basketball team come out, like the starting five come out as a group, and they play together for like 45 minutes with like middle-aged men and seventh grade boys, and you got a high school varsity team just out there running, and that's their practice.
That's ridiculous. That's fucked up. Like, how you gonna let the little dudes run all over these grown ass
little
men?
Dudes? Motherfucker, one of them was 6'6", one of them was 6'5". Like, they were on my
young dudes. How about that?
Four of them and me, and I didn't even. I was scared to shoot. I was scared to shoot on my own team. Like, I didn't want to look bad in front of these kids.
Yeah, I can't shoot. So, like, if we playing some ball, I'm Dennis Rodman on the court. I'm going to get all the rebounds, all the garbage points, and assist for days. I can't shoot worth a damn. Wow. It's bad. Like, it's real bad.
It's not bad. It just is what it is. Chase, do you know who I am?
You are Rashani.
No, I'm saying that seriously because in the long span of my podcasting life, which is like 11 years at this juncture, 12 years, I looked before I came on this show. Scar has been on my shows more than anybody else in the history of single simulcast, The Dream Team, Unburdened, 20 Minutes, Storytellers, or Hindsight. He's been on my show more than anybody, like not named Shantae, even more than Shantae, anybody. And this is my first time being on Scarcasm Live ever in my entire life. And
that's not true.
You were
on here in this previous incarnation.
Rest in peace.
But like, I figured, like, because we had the Dream Team, there's no reason for us to just, you know, like.
Dude, I act differently on other people's shows.
Me too.
Actually. I bring the fire to other people's shows.
I
say nigga a lot. Do you bleep it?
No.
No, I say nigga a lot here.
Nigga, nobody's talking. I'm talking to Chase. Chase. I act differently on other people's shows because it's fun. It's like going to other people's islands on Animal Crossing and shit. I'm going to kick all your bugs and eat your peaches.
I forgot you're a Switch person.
Hey, sometimes, you know, sometimes she sticks a finger out the booty. What can I say? I got to take it. Wait, what?
Wow. Okay, so let's go ahead and start the show. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Scarfinger. This is Scarcasm. Chase is in the building. Rashani's here. We are all here. We're going to get this thing rolling.
You goddamn right, I'm here. Play my music, theme music, bitches.
Let me ask y'all a question.
No, play me in. Oots, 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 gallawala, oots, gallawala, oots, gallawala, oots, gallawala.
This show is going to be all over the place, and it's going to be a pretty long show unless you got something else to do.
Slick DJs. Rashani's in here. Let's all play. Oots, 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 oots. Galawala, galawala. Oots, 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 and I'm out.
Okay, so I saw someone on Facebook today, mm-hmm. And I was kind of like taken back by it, and I wanted to jump in, but then I realized what room I was in, and I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna leave this alone. So. One of my old coworkers discovered that NAMBLA exists.
Oh.
And she went on this whole tirade about how we need to protect our children, blah, 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 whatever. And like a couple of people was just kind of like, yeah, this thing has been here. Like you late. Like this thing has existed. We're all surprised that it still exists, but it exists. And then this one dude said, like, this thing it exists. And it continues to exist because it was basically a whole bunch of white dudes. And we know that, you know, they're not really going to come for a whole bunch of white dudes. If it was black dudes in this group, this shit would have got canceled a long time ago. And now my coworker, my ex-coworker, is a white lady. She has two black children. She has two black teenage boys.
Oh, so she racist.
Just does exactly what I said. But see, here's the thing. I have this thing, right? When I talk to my girl about this, like, she thinks that, you know, she thinks that when I keep bringing all of this stuff up, it makes me seem like I am. And I'm just kind of like, yo, like having the conversations with her about like, yo, I got to be aware of my blackness at all times. Like, you know what I mean? And it's not like because I'm trying to be racist or anything like that. You know, this is survival. Like, I have to be aware of this and I have to be aware of what this means to the outside world. And, you know, like, so I talk to her a lot about like the stuff with like her grandkids. She has two black grandkids that eventually are going to be black women. So I talked to her about this quite often. And, but like when I saw this the other day and I saw her post something else and I'm like, do you realize that you have two black men that you are raising? And you have no idea what they're going to go through. Like, neither of their fathers are in the picture. Like, you are their sole caregiver. And you have no idea what these little dudes are going to go through when they leave you, when they leave your house and they go to do anything else. You have no idea what they're going to go through. But on this post, man, they gave that dude the blues. Why does it have to be? What does this have to do with race? This is about protecting our children. I mean, and they just kept going on. And all I did was put like two of those gifs of like people eating popcorn because they were just going. And so I just did that. And a couple of the people, including my ex coworker, actually like thought it was funny. And I was like, no, I put this popcorn because I'm watching y'all act the fucking fool and he's not wrong. And I wanted to say something, but I wanted to wait and see if any other black person said something because quite a few people said something, but none of them were black. So I waited and nothing happened. And then, so all I did was I tagged that dude in a post and I said, time and place, dude. And that's all I said because I didn't want to get too deep into it. But there was nothing wrong with what he said. In fact, he was quite correct, quite correct. And I don't know, should I have done more to stand up for this dude?
So I'm guessing that this conversation's for me because, you know, Chase, he said, you know, it's a me thing. I got this, Chase. Tag out. I got this. So the first thing I want to do is open up with a quote, because the quote that I use for this is going to explain to Amanda and everybody going forward why you were so fucking cautious as a black person. Not even as a black man, just a black person. And Chase, you can use this too. Matter of fact, everybody can use it. The reason why everybody can use it is because it's written by a white guy. The white guy wrote it in The Princess Bride. And the quote is quite simply, "You think this is a trap then," the count asked. I always think everything's a trap until proven otherwise, the prince answered, which is why I'm still alive. Scar, you think it's racist? I think everything is racist. That's why I'm still alive. I think everything is bad until you prove that it's not. You have to literally show me that it's not something that's going to be bad for me as a person before I go forward and do it. I wouldn't have gotten involved in that conversation at all. First of all, NAMBLA and black folks and white people just don't mix. Because as soon as you say something, they're going to be like, well, you're doing this. There's no way you're going to turn out well.
I'm in support of this thing.
There's no way you can win in this conversation. There's none. So you got to recognize that and just be like, you know what? I'm bowing out. I wouldn't even put up a gift. I would have just dipped. Because second thing is they're ex-coworkers. And I don't like talking to ex-coworkers. I don't like talking to current coworkers on Facebook because they know me in real life. And I've been dealing with a lot of stupid people recently who know me in real life, who have been saying a lot of weird ass shit about NAMBLA recently. I guess there's like these dolls, the LOL dolls.
Oh, you know what? I saw that, the thing where it has the button underneath. She posted that. That's why I saw that. She posted that.
So that somehow turned into George Soros is running Black Lives Matter, and NAMBLA is infiltrating the presidential election, and nobody's worried about it at all, which is why Donald Trump said that all these other women were nasty women, but for Epstein's right hand, Maxwell, he said that she's a nice woman and he hopes she's okay. And I was like, you know, this is all public, right? You're not just sending this to your wife. This is all public. And then Wet Ass Pussy came out. I can say Wet Ass Pussy, right? Chase, who's doing the editing on this show?
Chase edits.
Okay, Chase, I'm going to say Wet Ass Pussy because it's fun to say. It really is. And WAP is a stupid ass acronym. And WAP is a slur. So my wife was like, is it WAP or is it WAP? And I was like, one of those is a slur. So you should figure that shit out quickly before you go out in public. But because she was like sounding it out. She's a Virgo. She's weird. I love her.
I never heard the song, but I've used it to mess with my child.
A dude hopped into my comments and was like, yo, this song is horrible and I don't play it for my kids. I also don't play the radio. And then he went into how George Soros is funding Black Lives Matter. And then somebody else jumped in and was like, dude, you're so stupid as shit. And he said the thing that people say when they don't have anything else to say, which is do your research.
Oh my God. I'm sick of the do your research thing. It's not a matter of doing your research. The matter is where you do your research. Like, you can find anything to back up whatever the fuck you think. I mean, that is the social media. That is the fucked up part about social media, in general, because before people had fucked up thoughts about fucked up shit, but because of social media, people can find other people with those same fucked up thoughts about fucked up shit. Mm-hmm. And it's so much easier to find this, your tribe, I guess, if you're in this.
That's really what it is. It's a tribe.
Yeah. It's
funny. Back in the day, we were, when we were talking about the cult of, people, and they were getting mad about it. It's funny now that with social media, that's actually what's happening. People are finding one another and they're basing their thoughts off an echo chamber where nobody ever says, you know what, this is fucking stupid. And because nobody ever says this is fucking stupid, the thought gains strength until all of a sudden you got this movement, and that's where the Tea Party came from.
You know what? The whole thing about social media and the reason why, like, what we were just talking about, the bad part of it, is, like, the fact that you can find your tribe in this is the same reason why I've never seen anybody on Facebook go, well, you know what? You're right. I was wrong about that thought.
Like, I do it on the show at least twice an episode because
you do it on the show, but on like Facebook and stuff like that.
Ain't nobody admitting that.
When everybody's having a conversation about something, like, I've never seen a person go, you know what, you're right.
No, ain't nobody doing that. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Because you always got somebody to back you up. Always. Even if you could be ass wrong.
I'm upset. I have video games to talk about. That's crazy.
the video game people are worse.
Yeah, they are.
The video game people are worse. Every time I go to Twitter, it's like 10 years ago. People are still arguing Sony and Microsoft. And it's just like, nigga, what's wrong with you?
Can I be honest with you, Scar? You're still walking with the same group of people from 10 years ago, and you're shocked that nobody's changed. Like,
there's a couple of them.
A nigga who has his shit protected, and nobody gives a fuck what he has to say. Like, let's be honest. You run with fucking scalawags. Like, you run with a group of people where growth is impossible, and I'm one of them. And I had to get the fuck off Twitter because all they do is talk to one another and they bunch together like bugs under a rock. There's no growth pattern in there because there's not going to be anybody new to come in and be like, you know what, motherfuckers, we grown right now. This is what we're going to talk about. And so every time somebody comes in there and says, hey, let's talk about growth, the dude with the protected account is like, Jesus said. And then other people are like, I'm not hearing this. And then it all falls apart.
Right. It's just weird. It's just weird because I don't go to Twitter very often. Like, I have to be really bored and typically at work, bored at work before I was like, you know what? Facebook ain't got nothing new. So let me go ahead and go to Twitter and see what's popping over there. Now, generally, I only check my mentions, but every once in a while, I'm like, yo, y'all are still here.
Like, at work, you got it. At work, you can only check your mentions because you never know when somebody's going to post up a naked picture of somebody for no reason on Twitter.
Truth. And my desk is right near the door and it's wide the fuck open. So, like, and I got a nosy coworker that will, like, go past my desk and be like, oh, what's that?
Is that a nipple? That's a nipple because I'm drooling.
Yeah, that's why I had to, I had to block. I was in the bad black art group, I had to block that shit because, like, I can't have that shit come up while I'm at work.
Yeah, a lot of bad black art, Chase, is nothing more than men drawing pussies or men drawing women that they feel are unattainable because they're not a bad boy. That's bad black art for you. It's either a vagina with the earth coming out of it or it's a black man being left behind by a cute woman who's like, you're not hood enough for me. And then in the next scene, she's pregnant and a thug is walking out on her. Then in the next scene, she's going back to the guy that she left and was like, can you please take me back? He's like, no. Once you left me, I found myself and I became a multimillionaire.
And it's niggas with power dick fantasies.
Yeah.
Yeah, power dick fantasies.
Can
that be a show title?
It could be. I mean, in every picture, Chase, I don't know about white people. I've never been to bad white art. I don't like the museum. But I'm ching.
Isn't that deviant art?
That is true. And you know what? Here's how you know that you've gotten the deviant art or bad black art, because if they draw a dick, it has a minimum of 17 veins on it.
this shit, like, the dick is like going Super Saiyan and shit. Like,
the dick looks like Dom's arm in Gears of War. Like,
all of a sudden, the hair on the dick turns blonde and gets spiky all of a sudden. It's like, nigga, what the fuck is this?
I'm super slaying.
Super slaying. Yo, that's another title. That's another good title. Hold on. I do the opposite of the Dream Team.
Chase, we have a rule on our defunct show where whenever Scar said the name of a title out loud, we didn't run that shit at all. He burnt through like 6 titles per episode.
Yeah, sometimes I did it on purpose.
Because he knew I liked something.
Yep.
Yeah.
Now you have a new venture.
Another one. That's my DJ Khaled voice. Which, by the way, saw a movie. It's horrible. It's part of my new venture. Anyhow, saw a movie. DJ Khaled was on it. DJ Khaled was skinny. I shit you not. It was creepy.
What the fuck? What movie
was that? It came out a long time ago. It was Shadows.
I've never seen Shadows.
It's Jamaican gangsters, and it's so horrible. It's so bad.
I think that movie defies my 1.5 rappers rule.
No. There's not a lot of rappers in it. It's in Jamaica. And so it's all like they're talking. Like, I didn't know that if I went to Jamaica, I wouldn't understand what they were saying while they were speaking English.
Bruh, the second season of Luke Cage, I had to put the fucking subtitles on. Like, dude, I'm really terrible with accents. Other than country motherfuckers, like, I'm really terrible with accents.
It's not even accents. It's just the slang. Like, you watch a show that's in Britain, and you're like, okay, they say fam a lot. They say bruv a lot. They say all these things a lot, but you can still kind of understand what they say, isn't it? They say isn't it for everything. That was a pussy, isn't it? Bruv, fam, governor. But
the weird thing about British accents is, like, if there is a L in the middle of a word, it is like.
But Jamaica, they do not. I don't know. They gather their slang from everywhere, and they wield it like a bat with nails on it.
They wield it like Negan.
Mm-hmm. So it's like you're trying to figure out what's going on, but you keep having to look down at the subtitles, and they know that you're looking at the subtitles for a reason. You know, here's how you know when a show or a movie is out of your depth linguistically. When not only does the subtitles put the words at the bottom in closed caption, but they also change the words so then you can understand what the fuck they're saying.
Or has like the line and then has the translation already there.
That's exactly what
Shot. And they put them in different colors. Mm-hmm.
But yes, I have like new ventures. Which one are we talking about, the food or the show?
Both. Let's talk about the show first.
Okay, so I do a show. Scar was on the last one. See, because I put him on a lot of my shows, Chase. Did I mention he once, Chase?
He's been on the show several fucking times.
Once.
Several. In his previous incarnation.
Several is not really a number.
That was pre Dream Team. And once the Dream Team started happening, there was no reason for us to be around each other all the fucking time because you just get on my fucking nerves after a little while.
Hey, fuck you too, bro. I'm glad that you're finally being honest about something I'm good at. I've been trying to get on your nerves for like 10 years now.
I just don't let you see it.
Hey, Chase, the first time Scar and I met, I wanted to fight him. The last time Scar and I met is right now, and if I could reach through the computer screen, I'd choke him out. So either way it goes, bestie. So I do a show called Hindsight where movies that I thought were great when I was 10 and 11 and 12, we go back and watch them in 2020 with 2020 vision and find out, guess what? Yeah, the last one that came out on Sundays because I put my shows on Sundays because I'm different. Everybody else puts their shows out on Tuesdays. I put my show out on Sundays. They got McDonald's. We got McDowell's. You know how it goes. So the show we did
Does he get that reference?
I don't know. You?
No, he doesn't. This is Chase.
Chase, Chase, there's going to be subtitles for our conversation later on, and something's going to pop up at the bottom like a pop-up video, and it's going to say that's a reference from Coming to America, an Eddie Murphy movie in which he was a poor guy who was actually a prince, and while he was in Queens, he went to work at a place that wasn't called McDonald's, it was called McDowell's.
It's been a long time since I've seen that movie.
Yeah, white people are the bestest.
He was from a place near Wakanda.
Huh, where are you from, homie? Oh, you mean, yeah, Akeem. yeah, he's from Zamunda.
Ain't nothing Wakanda like in North Carolina where he is.
So the
Well, I did realize something today that Southerners are more progressive than they think because y'all is a gender neutral pronoun.
So is dude, but people won't accept it as such. Dude in California is gender neutral as you can get. They wrote a fucking song about it. I'm a dude, you're a dude, they're a dude, we're all dudes.
Really?
You know that song. You really? Sang it in your head. I know you.
Wasn't that like Good Burger or some shit?
It was. See, I knew that shit. So the last show that we did, it just came out on Sunday. Yesterday was, or when y'all get this, like 3 months ago. Scar was on it. We did a Hindsight for Boys in the Hood, and we realized that Trey's real name is Furious Styles III, and that he was a 23-year-old playing a 17-year-old with a 51-year-old face. And
I found out was supposed to be Will Smith, but they were filming The Fresh Prince before it actually officially came out.
I don't think Will Smith would have been able to carry the role either. They needed a 59-year-old man to pull off that role of a 17-year-old boy.
Yeah, pretty much.
Fucking, oh, just seeing that movie with his old ass face just ruins everything because when he turned around and says Ricky and his whole face turns pug wrinkled.
Yeah, he has that old man wrinkle forehead thing going.
He has the forehead of a 7-year-old who got sent to the corner a lot because they didn't know the answer, so they thought real hard. But yeah, so we get on there and we talk about movies, and quite often the movies we did this past month were Black Hood classics. So quite often they weren't as funny as I wanted them, or they could have been, because it was actual serious conversations. We did Above the Rim, which isn't a Black Hood classic, but it is to me. And then we did.
What do you mean it's not a Black Hood classic?
It's not.
Okay, so by this line of the conversation or whatever, then that means Belly is not.
That's a Black Hood cult classic.
No, that's not. Like, if Above the Rim is not, then Belly is not.
If you ask 10 people if they've seen Above the Rim, 4 of them might say yes. Because it's a basketball movie based out of California with Tupac in it. Or a basketball movie based out of New York with Tupac in it. So it's, and it was in the Death Row era, right in the midst of the East Coast, West Coast. There's a lot of different reasons why a lot of folks didn't choose to watch that movie. And I did, because I fell into every single genre that it was looking for.
Have you done Juice yet?
I'm never doing Juice.
I know you got stuff in the can.
Never doing Juice.
Why not? Because
on the docket. It just never grabbed me the way it grabbed everybody else. And y'all don't want to know what I think about Juice.
Okay, so here's the thing about Juice. And this is the only thing I'll say about Juice. I love the fact that it's like hey, these friends are like trying to do whatever the fuck, you know, we're living in the hood and all this kind of stuff. But like, if you think of it, the moment the gun comes into play, it becomes a horror movie.
Yeah.
And like, the moment the horror movie starts, that's when it actually gets good.
If you say so.
I wouldn't say it's great. But
I would honestly watch the program again before I watch Juice.
It's like one of those things that like one of my favorite movies, that one of my favorite terrible movies is The People Under the Stairs. Yes, if you watch The People Under the Stairs the way that it was intended, it's fucking terrible. But if you watch it as an unintentional comedy, it's gold.
Yeah, I just don't want to do that with Juice. I just hate it too much. I don't even know why I hate it. It's just like a unmatched ire for Juice. And it's sad because I fucking love Juice. I love apple juice. I love grape juice. I love orange juice. Pineapple Juice and me were fucking in the closet just a few hours ago. But Juice, ugh. And the last thing the nigga said was, "You got the juice now, homeboy." Like, that's supposed to be deep. Like, that's supposed to be just insight.
That's like the worst delivered line in the whole movie.
Right.
Like really bad. Like,
and let's go ahead and stop and just really, Chase, I have a fascination with people who only get one line in a movie. I have a real fascination with people who only get one line in a movie or a TV show. I think they're fucking hilarious. I love how they put so much of their life into this one line, because it's their one shot to really be seen. And so when you see a waiter who comes up and they say, "Are you ready to order?" No, I didn't say that right. Hold on. "Are you ready to order?" No. Let me get into the right feeling for this. Fall in the character. "Are you chaps ready to eat?"
And or, scene.
Even better, back in the 70s, folks would come out and say, "That jive turkey went that way.
Hey, man, I ain't even do nothing.
Hey, Jack, you better get off my grind." So the dude who said, "You got the juice now, homeboy," never seen in the rest of the movie. Motherfucker, yeah. Pops up from nowhere like Snoop Dogg and Half Baked to say, "You got the juice now, homeboy." Who the fuck is this? The juice fairy? Like, who, why? Why is this a thing?
That Snoop in Half Baked just kind of shows up like Vampire in Brooklyn, just kind of materializes. Like, what the where the fuck did you come from?
Oh yeah, long story short, never doing Juice. Also, the movies we did this month were Above the Rim, then we did Menace to Society, and then we did Boys in the Hood, and then we did New Jack City, and then we did Set It Off. And Set It Off is currently on Patreon, because that's the bonus reel that we do. And then after we do all the rest of the shows, we'll put that one out midweek.
Okay, let me. Okay, so I haven't listened to the show yet. I haven't listened to any of them yet, but they've all been downloaded. So you got your numbers. does Set It Off hold up?
Yes. Actually, here's what happened with Set It Off. And the spoiler alerts, because again, for anybody who's not a Patreon member, this shit doesn't come out for another 3 weeks. But Set It Off is actually one of the bleakest, grimmest black movies I've ever seen in my entire life. And it's all because men can't get the fuck out of women's way.
Wow.
Every bad thing that happens in that movie to those four poor black women is because men can't get out of their way. And it's crazy to watch. Like, as an adult, to really sit back and watch it is like heartbreaking to see the way that these things. Chase, there's a character. Her name is Stoney. Stoney has a brother. Stoney's brother's going to college. Stoney's brother, Stoney and her brother, their parents died in a car accident when they were young, so they've been orphans, and Stoney's been taking care of her brother. Like I said, bleak as shit. Stoney's brother is going to college, but Stoney's brother doesn't get a scholarship to go to college. In order for Stoney's brother to go to college, Stoney sleeps with the man that she finds to be completely disgusting so that he'll give her an advance on her paycheck. He's not even paying her enough money to send him to college. He's paying her enough money for the first payment. She goes back to her brother like, hey, I got the money for you to actually step foot in the college. And he was like, you know what? I was lying to you. I didn't actually make it into college. Surprise, motherfucker. After she sold her body to a guy that she doesn't even like. Like, it's a bleak-ass movie, and it only goes downhill from there.
Huh.
Her brother gets shot by the police, and it goes downhill from there. It's like literally a snowball that starts at the top of a hill of trash and just rolls all the way down, and the trash is men. I'm not even on that feminist shit, but seriously, this movie was quite simply like, y'all just need to get the fuck out of their way and let them cook the movie.
And Queen Latifah comes out of the closet.
No, but Queen Latifah gets misgendered the whole movie because the dude who's her boss just keeps on like sexually harassing her by saying ladies and gentlemen.
Wow. It's been a while since I've seen it. I'm going to have to go back and see some of these movies, because I watched a few like Menace to Society recaps.
Oh my God.
And I did the New York City recaps. New Jack City recaps, and those were fun. But like, I think I need to go back and actually watch these full fucking movies.
New Jack City is probably the only comedy we saw in the first five movies. No, New Jack City and Above the Rim. We made fun of Boys in the Hood because of Trace old ass face, but really that whole movie.
And his father's name is Furious.
Furious. Hey, he has it on his nameplate at his job.
I noticed. This is something that I noticed. It's like when they go to his job, it's like the name of the company is Furious Finance or some shit like that. Like,
I'm mad about money.
Is the name of the company is like Furious Finance or some shit like that. And it's just like, yo, his name is not just on his desk. It's on the building.
It's on the back of the women. Wait, we're past that now. I've matured. Scar and I once got into a whole conversation about licking armpits and getting deodorant mouth.
No, it wasn't. We were talking about FDS.
Yeah, and it's the same as licking an armpit, because that's what I was talking about, and getting deodorant in your mouth and just getting cotton mouth. Deodorant causes cotton mouth was an actual episode we did before we matured. We actually did an episode of the Dream Team called We Matured. Because we're horrible people who are just step by step. Come on, Chase, I know you know this one.
Yeah.
Step by step, day by day.
I don't think you want Chase to sing. I think that's a horrible idea.
I think Chase singing in a North Carolina accent will be the funniest shit I've heard in a long time.
Chase plays guitar. Like, it sounds like he's playing like one very long chord at a time.
Okay.
It's just
so next month's movies are Eddie Murphy movies. We're doing Boomerang, Life, Harlem Nights, Coming to America, and The Distinguished Gentleman.
Oh, that Distinguished Gentleman fall off is going to be grand.
Like, yeah, I've never seen it before, to be honest with you. No. Brandon wanted it.
Yo, the distinguished gentleman is fucking great because it's like, yo, this nigga got to be got on the ticket because he had a name similar to a nigga who died. And like, that's how he got onto the ticket. That's the whole premise of the movie. Somebody died and he had a similar name to it. So he was like, yo, I'm gonna run in his place, because like, people just vote for the guy with that name. So I'm just gonna make my name closer to his and we can run.
I mean, I don't see the problem in that theory. Like, there, it's,
I mean,
it works.
It was head of state before head of state.
I loved Head of State, and I told somebody else that like Head of State is one of the best political movies I ever saw. But everybody else wants to tell me about Bullworth with the rapping white dude.
Bullworth was terrible. Like, come on.
Yeah, can anybody admit that Bullworth was terrible just based on the fact that Warren Beatty should never rap again?
Yeah, and
what we need to do is we need to raise taxes because we don't know about the blacks.
The only thing good about Bullworth was Ghetto Superstar. Like, that is the only good thing about
Let's drill it down. The only good thing about Bullworth was Maya.
Okay. I can roll with that.
Yeah. I mean, I'm going to look real quick to just fulfill an idea or a thought that I have, but I'm pretty certain of something. Chase, you haven't talked in a while. Welcome to our world.
Yeah, this shit double dutch, bro. Like, you're going to have to just jump in. Like,
right. It wasn't Maya who was in the movie. It was Halle Berry who was in the movie as Nina. So, okay. Halle Berry was in the movie. Maya was in the video.
I saw one of the dudes that I've been watching these recaps, I saw him do a recap of Swordfish, and that was funny.
I've never seen it, but I heard she takes off her top. Like, I heard that's the reason why people came and saw it.
Yes, that was the initial reason, yes. It's not a great movie. And, like, the John Travolta pseudo-Euro trash look is just kind of off-putting. It's like, why do you look like that? Like, I like his look better in Battlefield Earth than Swordfish. Like, this is what we're talking about here. Like, that Battlefield Earth suited him better than his look in Swordfish.
I really want to make a movie where a song about John Travolta plays and it's just somebody saying, John Travolta, John Travolta, John Travolta. It's a musical sounding name. He makes me spark.
Rambleton? Like Hamilton, but with random songs from your brain.
Oh my God.
You're welcome.
What the fuck does that mean, Kobe Bryant?
Can we use that now? Because
I totally can. And also, it's funny to say that Kobe Bryant was the only person holding back COVID.
Yeah, because once the floodgates opened when he died.
Yep, he was the one person holding humanity together.
Yep, that was the beginning and the end for this year.
Like, come on, Chase, jump in.
What's up, guys?
Hey, Chase, how you doing, man?
Pretty good. Yeah, you and Scar are pretty tight.
Yeah, I know all of his secrets.
Yes. He knows where the bodies are buried.
I know where the bodies are buried. Hey, do you know what happens in Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic?
I will fucking cut you. I'm dead ass fucking serious. That's the one thing I won't spoil. Like, I don't spoil anything. I don't spoil Knights of the Old Republic. I don't, because that shit happened to me and it fucked me up. I got spoiled on that shit an hour before the twist fucking happened. So I refuse to do that to anybody fucking else. I don't give a shit if you're never gonna play the game ever. But like, no, I will not spoil that for anyone.
It's great, Chase, because he gets so offended. Like, I came out and said, Chase, have you seen my dick? Like, he's just like, no, sir. We've talked about this. No dick flashing. I just want to tell him what happens in KOTOR. It's important. Hey, Scar, look, you can log off for a second. I won't even tell Chase. I'll tell his significant other.
Haven't you played the game? But you didn't finish it, right?
I didn't finish it, man.
It was pretty dope. I didn't finish the very last fight because I didn't feel like it. Like, I find that this happens to me a lot. I get through all of a game, and then I get to the final boss, and I'm like, well, that's it. And I'm just like, I'm going, I can move on to another game. I've gotten here.
That almost happened to me last week. I played a game that I don't normally play. I actually finished it, but I got to the end and I was just kind of like, okay, I think I'm done with this. And then something really fucking cool happened and it turned out to be the best thing in the whole fucking game.
What game was it?
I finished Gears 4 finally.
Oh, I still have not.
And let me tell you, like, that game sucks. It's not an enjoyable game at all.
This comes from two motherfuckers who sat up all night long once playing Gears of War 3 Horde mode or Gears of War 2 Horde mode.
I think it was 2.
It was 2.
Yeah. Let me tell you, that game is not enjoyable until the last fucking part. The last fucking part, you get to pilot a big fucking Gears of War mech through the end of the fucking game. And that is the most enjoyable part of that whole shit. Like, I'm not even worried about spoiling that because, like, if you haven't finished Gears 4, like, I'm cool with that. But, like, if you want to finish it, shit at the end, because, you know, apparently Baird is that nigga. So, like, you know, like, Baird came up with these fucking
Power Zoid,
30 feet tall fucking Transzor Z fucking Gears of War robots.
Do they play Kanye West Power in the background?
I wish.
You can, I mean, it and Xbox and Spotify together, you can just, like, play it yourself.
Yeah, that's not the same.
It doesn't work the same. It doesn't work the same like Saints Row 3.
Because if you don't get it on beat, like, I feel like there's only two songs you can really play in a moment like that. It's either Power or else the Final Countdown.
Does the Final Countdown work in that scene?
Not the intro, not the chorus. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the harmony of it. The actual first verse of the Final Countdown is pretty fucking fetch. Which, by the way, I've been trying to fit that into a conversation.
Stop trying to make fetch happen.
Fetch is going to happen, you fetch, punk fuck.
Stop trying to make fetch happen. It's not going to happen.
So the Final Countdown, the actual music of the Final Countdown, Scar is a sampleologist. I am a beat wizard, so I hear the actual rhythm of the song, and I'm like, it's dope. And the harmonizing of the song. Scar hears the bones of the song. I hear the flesh of it.
I would save the Final Countdown for, like, something like a fucking, airplane or a space battle. Like, that sounds like befitting of some shit like that. Like, not like that Top Gun shit, because the Top Gun, that shit doesn't work for anything. Like, it doesn't even work for fucking Top Gun. But, like, you put the Final Countdown in some shit like that in fucking Top Gun, or like some Star Wars shit, put it at the end of fucking episode 4 when Luke fucking does the thing, and like have the Final Countdown playing behind that shit. Fuck yeah, man, that shit works.
Check out the harmony. Here it comes. See, it doesn't have to be the whole song. Just put that first verse in there with the harmonizing while he blows up like one of those big guys with the rockets on their back and, you know, penis arms are just like,
and everybody. Oh, you totally have to take out a very giant tentacle monster at the end of Gears 4.
Exactly, with that music.
I can see
it. Or the music where Rocky's running up the stairs.
We can't rep for Rocky.
The music for victory, you know.
Yeah. I know. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I would just put victory. Like, I wouldn't put the Rocky music. I would just put victory.
Victory would be dope. I don't even like Puffy, but I like victory. I like the fact that, first of all, Chase, have you heard victory?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you know the best part of victory is the fact that the best part of victory is Biggie literally talking over Puffy's entire verse.
No. It's him. He's like, yeah. No, the mic. Turn the mic up.
He didn't even say nothing for
you. Yeah. The mic is low. Turn it. Yeah. Now it's too low. Like, it's too low. Turn it up. I was like, he's just talking. the whole shit. He's just kind of like
the best part of it is that Puffy's like, yeah, it is better that way, because Puffy's the one who put the track together.
It's kind of like that that interlude on Lil Wayne's album where Tech N9ne is rapping, mm-hmm. but it sounds like Tech N9ne takes the microphone away from Lil Wayne if you pay attention to it, because mm-hmm. Lil Wayne is like and then all of a sudden it's like he just snatches the shit. it's like he snatches the fucking microphone away from him. Like, that's some shit you have to do.
You gotta do that shit to Puffy. He wasn't even ad-libbing. He was just talking to Puffy, who's the producer, while he's prepping for his lines, while like it's like if you rewind the track and you're like gearing up for gear parts, so you think you're muted and you're like, I farted, and Puffy's like, that works.
You guys know that Tech N9ne's Red Country is getting co-opted?
No,
he's a Tech N9ne fan. I'm not.
I am.
I don't know his, I don't know. I'm not like a hater or anything. I just don't know his music like that.
And I tried for years.
I just don't care.
But the, I've seen videos to where it'd be like, it's Red Country, and it'd be like a bunch of Trump signs and stuff.
Oh God. Well, I mean, honestly, Strange Music is, I'm not going to say it's completely on its last legs at this point in time, but if Tech retired, I wouldn't be mad. Ritz's contract ended. Calico's contract ended. Brother Lynch's contract ended. And now it's just Tech N9ne and like his, I don't know who Mackenzie is, if she's a family friend or Travis's daughter or Travis's wife or girlfriend. I don't know who she is. I
Why just has it know. Followed it? Is it still like mostly like horror rap and stuff?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
I don't trust Chase on rap music at all. Like, I don't trust nothing. Like, I tried to introduce him to some cool shit, and he's just like, "Nah,
What are you trying to introduce him to?
All kinds of shit. I tried to get him to listen to Prick. I tried to get him to listen to Little Brother. He said he likes more of that 90s style rapping. Like, he can't get with Southern rap. So I was like, okay, Little Brother, it's right here. They're from North Carolina, not too far away from where you are. This is what you should be listening to.
When he said 90s rap, Scar, you got to remember there's variants of the 90s style rap. And one of the variants of the 90s style rap is boom, get in the boom, get in the boom, boom.
Food Snickers, yo. I know that's Dos Effects, but Food Snickers. I used to love the Food Snickers.
I'm riggedy rapping. Do you know, and it hit me in the face, that at one point Jay-Z was rapping like that?
Absolutely. Yes.
Like, not even like on Jigga What, Jigga Who, where he was rapping fast. He was literally doing the Food Snickers style of rapping. Absolutely. And that blew my mind.
Yes. Hawaiian Sophie and all of that kind of stuff. Yes, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Because he wanted to be, he tried so hard to be like Jazzo at the time. He named himself Jay-Z. His name is Sean. Where the fuck did Jay-Z come from? So, but anyway, it's funny. Oh, I found something out. I was listening to a podcast, and it's a music podcast, and it's called Speed of Sound, I think it's called. Yes, it's called Speed of Sound, and it's about like some musical history type stuff. And it was a thing about Rapper's Delight, but they started talking about like origins of like Sugar Hill Records and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Did you know one of the first groups that were signed to Sugar Hill Records was a group of three women called The Sequence?
No.
One third of The Sequence is Angie Stone.
Oh, really?
Yeah, rapping.
Like Angie with the nostrils.
Angie Stone. No. Kelly Price got the nostrils.
Oh, okay. Angie Stone was D'Angelo's girl.
Yes.
Okay. You sure she ain't got the nostrils too?
No, I don't think. She was just chunky.
Yeah, she was cute though.
But apparently she almost. Like, I mean, the whole D'Angelo thing was really kind of like fucked up for her, because like once he made it big, it was just like, why are you with her?
Yeah, and he started believing.
Yeah, and then but apparently she almost kind of closed the deal with Idris Elba too.
She's beautiful.
Yes.
Fucking gorgeous.
Yes.
With some Yeah. Okay. Sorry. Let's keep going.
I heard that on the podcast and I was like, that can't be true. So I went and I found her Unsung. And that is 100% accurate.
Yeah, I'm looking at it now on TMZ. VH1 snubbed me. The sequence were hip hop pioneers.
Yep.
It's a real video. It happened.
Yep. I'm like, for some reason, I'm really getting into these like music podcasts with like Questlove Supreme and all this kind of stuff. I'm really not listening to a whole lot of video game stuff anymore at all.
Well, I mean, honestly, in my humble opinion, which isn't so humble and really isn't an opinion, it's facts, yo! Video game podcasts, everybody talks about the same game that came out the same week. There's not really a lot of diversity in the staffing of video game podcasts. And more often than not, they tend to just be kind of rote. Scared to say what they actually feel, and they end up being played out pretty quickly.
But the original intent of the show was for me to be that diversity, to like bring that shit in. But like, I'm just kind of like, I don't know, for the first time in a long time, I actually played games that wasn't just The Division. Like,
well isn't it sort of like sometimes where I remember you talked about how you notice how video game podcasts or podcasts in general was this or that. There was this part of you and only that, or this part of you and only that, but you wanted to make a show that was everything that spoke to you, and you were figuring, there's got to be more people that speak to everything that I like. And sometimes it's really hard, because I'm actually the same way when it comes to like music, and I remember making playlists and stuff, and I would like stream them on Facebook or whatever for just some friends, and some people would really check in and be like, oh man, I like this song, and then they would check out because it would be like too diverse. Like, the you know, the people that might like hip hop would check in, and then once a metal song come out, they check out, and then the metal people would come in. But I'm like, isn't there anybody that just listens to everything? And normally when people say I listen to everything, that means I listen to everything but rap and country, or I listen to everything but rap and metal, because
I listen to everything except country and some of that weird metal shit that you like. I'm just kind of like, nah, we good.
So have you heard Ginger?
Yes, I've heard Ginger. Yeah,
I love Ginger so much. I think they're phenomenal. And Scar, let me clue you in on Ginger. Ginger is a death metal group.
Okay.
And they are headed up by the only woman in the world who can actually do vocal scarring. So she can sing like Gwen Stefani in one moment, and then the next moment she's, like with that, not even that, but like gravelly death metal Scandinavian voice.
Word. Speaking of Gwen Stefani, I when my daughter was here, we were talking about how like when you get famous, you just kind of change, and like, so I showed my daughter the video for Trapped in a Box, and I was like, that is Gwen Stefani, the same Gwen Stefani as this shit is bananas. These don't seem like the same people, but it's like sometimes you're not just plain or ugly, sometimes you're just broke.
Well, if you really want to blow her mind, show her Pink's first couple of videos and then show her Pink now.
No, I refuse. I don't fuck with Pink at all. Like, nope.
Nobody should, but you know.
Nope. Ever since the fucking the Lady Marmalade video where she tried to be all funny style because people showed up in furs, because apparently she's like super PETA, whatever the fuck. Like, you doing a song with a whole bunch of very rich people, like somebody gonna show up with a fur or some leather or some shit? Like, what the fuck you think? Like, how are you just gonna be mad because they showed up in the furs that they paid for themselves? Like, you don't give a shit about them animals? Sorry. the only thing that I feel really bad about is, like, I was in a pet store like years ago. I was in a pet store and I actually saw a chinchilla, and I was like, yo, how many of these fucking things do they have to kill to get a coat? Like it was like, that was the only time I've ever actually had that thought. Like, wow, you have to kill a lot of these fucking things in order to get a coat.
Minks are pretty small too. But mink feels wonderful.
I don't know. I ain't never going to have no mink. Like, that just don't seem like mink. Just the name mink just don't sound right to me.
They're adorable. They're adorable little creatures.
It's like having a fucking ferret coat. Like, why would you do that? Like, why the fuck would you do that? But chinchillas are so little and fucking adorable. And then, like, the idea is like, yo, they made, like, fucking, you see someone, like, I don't know, let's just throw this out here, like, Aretha Franklin. Like, do you know the amount of chinchillas that gotta go into that coat? It's a full-length fucking coat on Aretha Franklin. Like, do you know how many of these fucking things have to die for that coat? Like, you know, that's what I start thinking about.
I don't think about any of it because I can't afford one of those fucking coats. So I don't, it's not even on my list. Like, I don't think about certain things I can't afford. Lamborghinis.
Chinchilla
coats. In-N-Out Burger.
In-N-Out Burger. Wow.
Chinchilla coats.
Is In-N-Out Burger expensive? I don't know. They don't have them here.
No, I'm just...
So when you make it big, you're going to roll up on In-N-Out Burger in your Lamborghini wearing your chinchilla coat. Feel like I made it.
Oh, no. When I make it big, the first thing I'm buying is a mega cage. Scar, I showed you that, right?
Yes. I thought you bought one.
I did. I'm going to buy another one. Bowling!
When does that come in? Like September?
January.
What? Wait, you got to wait till January?
Yeah, it's going to be for my birthday. They got to custom make it.
Wow. Hey, I seen the most, like, weirdest fucking shit today.
The most weirdest. Let's go.
I seen some fashion show. It had someone with, like, this, like, flowery shirt and all this kind of stuff. Like, it's probably chinchilla or some shit. But it was a turtleneck. And the turtleneck was designed to look like the top of some Tim's. What, like, the nigga, it's the most New York shit ever. It was a fucking, the turtleneck looked like the top of some Tim's with laces and shit.
So the neck was there and then it was open here because you had to lace it up.
It was inside of the shirt, so it was like, you know, like, it was like,
yeah, an ass. But it was like the tongue, and then there were,
it was like a fucking, it was a fucking Timberland ascot. Like, it was like, what the fuck is this? I've never seen this shit before. It was the weirdest fucking thing. But yeah, it was at some sort of fashion show. They had fucking Timberland ascots with laces, dog. Like, why do you have laces on this?
People make me sad. Also, it's probably available at Macy's, which is why Macy's going out of business.
Yes. I got a homeboy that works for Macy's in Texas, though.
Sorry to hear it.
There's Macy's in Texas?
Not for long.
He works one in El Paso.
Not for long. You should probably call him and console him pretty soon.
That seems like an idea.
It's not even insider trading to tell you to take your stocks out. Cash out.
All right, so what do you want to get into first? We've already talked a little bit about what we've been watching because, like, you've been watching your movies. Oh, you never talked about your food, dog.
Yes, I did not.
Talk about your food, man.
I have a company. It's called Consistently Good because it is, and we make all kind of stuff. But for some strange reason, I don't know. I don't get it. It's like, you know. It's like people just want our ribs and brisket and prime rib and chicken. It's like, I don't know. Like, we make all this other stuff and all they want is our barbecue. Like, it's fucking fall off the bone ribs or something like that. I don't know. I don't get it. But it's like it's like the juices are just like dripping off the brisket when you take it out. I don't know. I don't get it. I don't understand. Cause I really just want people to try out my crab and shrimp in a white wine sauce over tilapia, but they won't. They just keep trying the brisket and the ribs and the prime rib and the chicken. And we I don't know, maybe it's because we smoke our chicken and then we, you know, do other tremendous stuff to it and make salt. We make lemon peppered smoked chicken wings. Maybe that's the reason. Maybe it's because we're on level 9 and other people are on level 2.
Lemon pepper what?
Smoked lemon pepper chicken wings.
But not wet, though.
They wet enough, nigga. Yeah, breathe deep and think about how that would take him out. The smoke. Think about a smoked
turkey. I don't think Chase got that reference either.
Think about it. Think about a smoked turkey leg flavor, except it's chicken and then lemon pepper. Exactly. Chase, you're making the face. Also, we like to go out and give videos of everybody taking their first bite because they don't believe that it's good. And this one kid on my basketball team, you'll never believe it. He took a bite and he said, I didn't expect it to be this good. And we were like, wait, what? And he was like, yeah, when you said it, I didn't believe it. And then he completely ate the rest of the rib that his mom didn't even get a chance to try. It was fucking glorious. We're good at it. We're good at everything. We're the best. But everybody keeps buying the shit that, you know, one person comes out and says our ribs are the bomb. And all of a sudden, everybody wants to try them because they are. Spoiler alert. Mm-hmm.
Get some food. That food be looking good as a motherfucker, though. But, like, you're on the complete other side of the earth as far as I'm concerned. So, like,
right? And that's the reason why I haven't really started sending out food is because I remember what happened when you sent me cookies.
Yes. That did not go well.
Yeah. See, we have a relationship, Chase. He sent me cookies when he had a cookie company for, like, 2 months.
I should tell you how I make my cookies so you can add it to your menus.
Email me the recipe. Nisha can do it, but Nisha does cookies already. You know what I did? Oh, my God. So.
Did you just cream yourself?
So.
This nigga just creamed
it. It's a great movie. Y'all should watch that because she does that a lot. So.
Which movie?
Easy A. Okay. It's got Emma Stone in it. It's like the remake of The Scarlet Letter, but it's a comedy. It's really good. I really enjoyed it. I actually bought it. But I took apple pie filling and caramels, and I put them in a pan. And then, so I put the apple pie filling at the bottom of the pan. Well, butter at the bottom of the pan. Then apple pie filling. And then I took some brown sugar and stuff, and I put brown sugar on top of it. And then I took caramels, and I cut up the caramels, and I put them on top of the apple pie filling. And then I took vanilla cake powder, like not even batter, and I made an apple pie dump cake and topped it off with ice cream. And I have diabetes now.
Shout out to Wolfram Brimley, who just passed.
From diabetes. It was good. It was so good.
That sounds good, but it sounds very, very sweet.
It was, according to Bella, I refuse to believe it. You know, y'all Virgos, she's one of you too, so.
Yeah. Sorry.
Hey. I'm stuck it in her mom at the wrong time, what can I say?
Yeah. My parents too. Like, when it's cold outside, that's pretty much what happened.
Yeah, who are you holding?
Another reference Chase doesn't get.
I love how he actually took the ad-libs that he didn't have to take and put them into his song, though. Shit, if y'all don't mind!
Oh,
she's always complaining about the things she ain't got time.
Who actually? I always get those like there's like four dudes that always get like confused. Like not the KC version. Like who did the original?
Womack, I think.
Yeah, I always get like Womack and like Johnny Taylor and like a few others. Like always get them confused because they all sound the same to me.
Let's see. Yeah, it was Bobby Womack. Bobby Womack was a player. Player.
Hold on, which one is the one that showed at Sam Cooke's funeral in one of his suits with his wife?
Player.
And also, like, out of all these dudes, like, which one did the Engine Number 9 song? That song jams. Oh, that's Wilson Pickett. So, like, see, same, all of them make the same music and always get them confused. But Engine Number 9 is, like, the shit, though. Please tell me you know what that song is.
No.
Oh, my God. That song is the shit.
On February 26, 1965, 77 days after Sam Cooke's death, 20-year-old Womack and Cooke's widow, Barbara Cooke, who was 10 years his senior, attempted to marry the Los Angeles County Courthouse. Playa.
Yeah,
this Womack dude wore one of Cooke's suits to the courthouse, and the media was present to record the event, but their application was rejected. According to the Los Angeles Sentinel, it was denied because Womack was under 20 years old and did not have his parents' permission to marry. Dick Pro! They were finally married on March 5th, the day after his 21st birthday. Their marriage was considered a scandal by some in the music business, and Womack found himself ostracized in the soul music world. Womack's brothers turned against him, as did his audiences and disc jockeys. Cook's family was also enraged. His brothers, Charles and David Cook, broke Womack's jaw during an attack.
Yeah, they had real beef. Like him and Sam Cook had real beef. So, like, this nigga shows up to his funeral with his wife. Like, you know what I mean? Like, yo, that was real beef. That's, like, I can't even imagine. Get some shit like that happen now. Like, I mean, the closest thing that we got is, like, what was it? Like, Kodak Black tried to holler at Lauren London after Nipsey died or something like that?
Yeah, but on the other hand, he was a fucking piece of shit molester, trash asshole.
True. Who
was molesting his 17-year-old stepdaughter, so.
Truth. Yeah. All truth. It's like when you like listen to a lot of these like podcasts and stuff like that talk about music history, like there are no good people. Mm-hmm. Like there are very, very, very few good people. They are all pieces of shit in some way, shape, or form. And like most people just know the music, so like it's just one of those things. But yeah, you show up to your enemy's funeral with his wife wearing.
If somebody shows up to my funeral with my wife on their arm, please shoot them. Please shoot them. Like, yo, just for me. Just shoot them, and then you can look at the sky and say, the boy here says he owes me. Like, you can scream at the sky all you want. Chase, Scar doesn't like to talk about this very much, but back in the day, there was this game called KOTOR, and if you played it long enough and you got to a certain section, what's that threatening thing mean? Why are you pointing at the screen and then punching yourself?
I'll punch you in your fucking eye. Like, that's what that is. I mean, no one else is going to see that, but...
Getting threatened online is the best. I used to threaten our kids the same exact way, which, in hindsight, they were six, so probably not the best way to shut them up is Sunday school. But at the same time, results. You know, you point at them, you make a fist in your eye, and then you hold up three fingers, which means I'm going to punch you in your eye three times if you don't sit down. They were six. They learned quickly. I never actually hit any of them.
I just fuck with Pooh Bear now. Like, you know, we had a conversation, and one day she just wanted to start some shit. Just like bored, and was just like, I just want to argue with somebody. And I was like, all right, cool. So I let the argument go on, and we had the conversation about WAP. And WAP. Then, and at the end of the conversation, I was like, look, you're gonna hate me for this, but I'm like, you wouldn't exist without WAP. She was like, I hate you.
Yo, that's the same conversation we had on single simulcast. We were talking about how many people really don't know how to talk to their significant others about sex and what they want out of a relationship and how to speak up for themselves sexually.
Fucking weak ass Ben Shapiro.
That's exactly what we were talking about. How he went and my doctor wife told me that this might be trichinosis. It might be a yeast infection that's making your wife's vagina wet. I don't know.
No, I've never seen it before. It's because you a herb and can't make it rain.
Oh gosh.
All right. So let's talk about games we've been playing, because I want to talk about games I've been playing, but we're gonna let Chase go first since he's talked the least.
Hi, Chase.
Hey.
Yeah, I have not really been talking, have I?
No. I mean, there was another white guy on Scar's show before. Rest in peace, Jay Bird, and it pretty much went the same way. People spend like half the show trying to draw Jay Bird out into a conversation, and Jay Bird would say one word and then go right back.
No, Scott was similar too. Like, Scott would just kind of like take a back seat. Like, that was back when I was using, I can't remember the program, but it recorded our tracks separately from each other. Mm-hmm. And like, I would just look at my track and it was just like up and down, up and down, up and down. And his is just kind of mostly like, just like a flat line, and he'll say something here and then flat line. He'll say something there, flat line, say something there. That was bad.
Shout out to that dude. He was a good dude. I wonder what happened to that dude.
Scott's going to be on the show. Was it next week?
I don't care.
The last.
So he's going to be on the 30th?
Yeah. Next week is Blue 31st. And Elaine.
Okay.
Blue, he's my boy. if you don't do it, you're not a good person.
But yeah, you know, let the guests talk, and you guys have a history, so I mean, and you guys got some inside jokes, and I'm just like, you know, I'm just smiling.
We don't really have jokes. We're deadly serious.
We did. He did the exact same thing when we had Marcus on the show. Was it the first August?
Yeah.
And we had Marcus on the show, and like, he didn't realize that me and Marcus actually knew each other. Like, so like, he just kind of went, wait, what the fuck just happened here? He had that look on his face the whole fucking time.
Sooner or later.
Yeah.
Games.
Yeah. I've only been playing one game, which is Destiny. I kind of got a lot back into that.
Okay.
And I didn't think I would, but yeah, it sucked me back in, mostly because I've been able to play with my wife, because we haven't been able to play something that we really enjoyed in a while. And we did play Destiny.
Yeah, kids.
Yeah. We did play Destiny in...
I think that went clean over your head. Fine.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it is true. I mean, that's the reason I stopped playing Destiny 2. Not because I didn't like the content. It's because by the time that Osiris came out is when Riley was born. And I remember...
I ain't talking about the fucking game. I'm talking about you talking about playing with your wife, and that kind of slowed down.
Yeah. Like,
kids. young Rouse is in the building.
Yeah. Well, all that. So, all that true. Mm-hmm. But I remember... I was like, man, I'm gonna play some Destiny in like 2017 or whatever. And I got into a public event, and all of a sudden I was needed, and I was like, I cannot pause this. And then by the time that I was like, yeah, I probably need to stop playing this because, or anything that I can't pause for a while. But now it's a little bit different. He's like almost three, and it is a little bit of where we still can't play during the daytime or anything. But we don't really want to, because if you play during the daytime, for some reason, it just makes you feel like shit. Like, I mean, just like, it feels like you slept too much. I mean, at least to me. I don't know, maybe it's that I game in this fucking kitchen chair. But,
likely.
But yeah, and we also played Destiny on the PS3, and we had two PS3s, so we played together, and that's the last time that we actually played Destiny together. So that's been, that was in 2014. Wow. That was 6 years ago. So it's been fun. And there's a lot of shit that we haven't done. So like, a lot of people that are like really hardcore in Destiny are like, the content's kind of dwindling out. I was like, really? It seems we're overwhelmed with content because we haven't played since like 2017. But yeah, so we're trying to just go through different things, and it seems like the new expansion got pushed back to November, so it's still like this current season, and we've already made it to like 1050, which caps 1060. So we did a lot of leveling and stuff, so it's been fun, and we found a pretty good group, which consists of Dickie William and all them, Pantless Steve, and from I don't even know.
Are y'all all playing on PC?
Well, they play on PC and Xbox. But and Amber does too. So, and, I mean, I jump on there on the Xbox every now and again if I just want to be on the couch. But I mostly play on PC.
It's not crossplay, but it's
cross save.
It's cross save. Okay.
Yeah, and all the. What's weird is the expansion in November. It's like a lot of the shit that released year one. I think it's getting destroyed or something, or whatever. There's these like giant pyramids or something. So a lot of that stuff is just going away. Like you won't even have access to do those raids or go to those areas anymore. It's basically Destiny 3, but they're not wanting to do a sequel. They're just wanting to kind of reset Destiny 2, or what they call sunsetting, which is something that MMOs do, but Destiny has never did it before. So I'm kind of curious to see what they're going to do with it. But
word.
I mean, the shooting mechanics and all that, still spot on. I mean, anybody, I can understand when people don't like the grind or whatever, but people still shit on Destiny, but they can't, they're lying to themselves if they don't think the actual game mechanics are bad, because Bungie makes good shooting.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So, but yeah,
I don't know. I tapped out when the paid content started. I completely tapped out.
I have a question.
What's that?
You said PlayStation 3. That was a typo, right? Like you really meant PlayStation 4?
No, because he was talking about playing Destiny 1 with his wife
in 2014. Because it.
Oh, I thought you meant like recent. I was like, wait, what? Like no, wait, no. Okay, I was gonna buy you a system. I was getting worried. Like no, this is not the legacy we leave our children.
Yeah. It was so funny because we started on PlayStation 3, and when we got a PS4, we played for a while, and then there was just, we still had some friends that were still a console generation behind, and when we jumped back on the PS3 to play with them, and Amber literally thought something was wrong with the PlayStation. She was like, this isn't what it looks like. What is going on? Is the TV mess? I was like, no. This is what it looks like on the PS3. She's like, holy shit, this looks terrible.
Yeah. PlayStation 3 games. I saw a couple PlayStation games a couple days ago, like literal original PlayStation games, and they did not age well, fellas. Like,
no, they did not. I saw someone, I saw a retrospective on NCAA football. And those PlayStation games is just like, whoa, my imagination must have been fucking fantastic because I actually saw people there. There is nothing close to people there at all.
Yeah.
Not even in the least.
And that's also a cool thing about emulation too, because yeah, the textures aren't going to be new, like really realistic textures. But you can, because I remember playing, I think it was like Silent Hill 1, and I was like, man, everything's so jaggy. But then when you do emulators and stuff, you can render all that stuff at like 4K if you wanted to. Yeah, it's not going to have like grass, but everything's going to be super, like really smooth and whatnot. And it does look a lot better. But yeah, just PS1 in general is hard to go back to. But once you initially start playing and you're like, holy shit, this looks terrible. If it's a game you really like and you start playing it, after a while you kind of get used to it. At least I do.
I'm not a whole lot of like, I'm not very nostalgic for most things.
Yeah. But anybody that says, oh man, this game looks crazy, I don't think I can go back to it, and it's like a 360 game, I'm like, dude, it's pretty easy to go back to the 360 here. Like, PS1 is kind of tough. PS2, maybe a little tough, but it's a lot better. But, like, 360, PS3 era, I mean, come on, get out of here. Now you're just being spoiled.
Yes. I think so. You did play something else.
Oh, yeah. We played some Gears 2, and that was super fun.
That's the reason why I ended up playing Gears 4.
But, yeah, because it's actually been 2 weeks since we recorded, because my wife's birthday was on last Monday, and actually our guest Wormhole Matt was out of town on a camping trip anyway. He forgot about it. So
and I said, well, when do you want to reschedule to? He was like, okay, I'll figure it out. And then nothing.
Yeah, because the next week was more guests, so I was like, we might tack it on at the end if he wants to do it, but, you know. So.
Okay. All right, so I'll go because I know Rashani got a whole bunch of, like, Switch games that he plays, and I'll let him go last.
Okay.
All right, so I did get back into playing some Division recently, and it just kind of feels like home. Because I've been playing Ghost Recon Breakpoint for a while, and those are very, very different games. Kind of similar premises, but those are very different games from each other. And like going back to the Division is just like, wow, I remember this. I remember actually action and not having to take a helicopter everywhere and lasted fucking 15 minutes before I get to the next part of the fucking action. And so I did that. And then, of course, like I said, I played Gears. After we played Gears 2, I decided to go back and try to finish Gears 4. I've already talked about that. I played the very, 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 very beginning of Gears 5. I didn't get very far at all. I just started it. And then it was just kind of like, no, I don't really want to do this right now. So I did that. I played, I started playing UFC 4. It just came out. It just came out Friday, I think. The new UFC, the EA UFC game. And just like every other UFC game, it's really, really fun until you have to go to the ground. And that's when everything just fucking sucks. They've made some like changes to the game to try to make the whole ground part easier. But like, I still fucking hate it. Like, I mean, If I could have that type of game and it was just like the stand up part, where not just like people are always clamoring for like fight night and shit like that, but like if you could like do like fight night with kicking and shit, like let's just do that. How about somebody make that into a fucking game? I don't want to roll around on the fucking ground with another dude. I'm sorry. That's just not my thing. That's the reason why I don't watch the UFC in the first place.
The rolling around is.
No, fuck it. They spend way too much time between each other's legs, and that's the reason why I can't watch the UFC.
That's the jujitsu part.
It's weird looking to me. And they spend so much time between each other's legs.
You know what I'm going to say next. That's why you're talking over me, because you know I'm going to tell you to grow up.
They spend so much time between each other's legs that there's different names for the different positions that they are between each other's legs.
Because it's an actual style.
I just don't enjoy that part of it in a fucking video game, but I don't really like it because it's just kind of weird. Because, like, you know, brother, like missionary with her legs up and her toes up on it, and then like seeing dudes do that is just kind of weird. it's just weird, like seeing dudes between each other's legs and then his legs are up, and it's just kind of.
Scott, can I ask you a question?
What?
You're watching a show or a movie.
Mm-hmm.
There happens to be a homosexual couple in it.
Mm-hmm.
They kiss.
Mm-hmm.
You still cover your eyes?
Nope. No. I'm good for it.
But do you care about MMA?
I just don't want to watch that. And then, like, people
I saw a movie a couple days ago. What was I watching?
But, like, people between each other's legs and like, hitting each other. Like,
I May Destroy You. The new show that started on HBO with Michaela Cohen, the woman who made Chewing Gum, it's on Netflix.
I don't even know what Chewing Gum is, so like.
Okay, cool. So, one of her best friends is a gay black man, and he actually finds a guy on Grindr, and him and his boyfriend go to meet this guy, and long story short, he ends up getting assaulted. But prior to getting assaulted, they are having sex. And so I was sitting there and I was like, damn, this is where I am in 2020. I'm watching two men have sex in a scene in a TV show on HBO. And I'm like, you know what? Yeah, it's all leading to something.
I've watched Oz. Like,
but you can't watch MMA. What the fuck, bro?
It's just weird. It's just weird to me. Like, they spend way too much time down there. I like to see them, like,
stand up. But isn't that the most efficient way to take down somebody? Not to, like,
but it's
take
the
punches,
most,
but to
But it's the most boring part. Like, that shit is the most boring part to me. Like, there is nothing, to me, there is nothing fun about
watching. You're like, stop cuddling. I want to see some poundage.
Basically. Hit him really hard.
It's not dirty. I mean, kind
of. UFC fights.
I mean, honestly, Chase, can I talk to your significant other for a second? I have questions.
Oh, she's gonna tell too much.
Like, she'll like tell she too much.
About, yeah, she told us about their encounter. We're having a sexual encounter to a very, very short metal album, and Chase arrived before the end of this. How long was it?
She didn't even get a chance to expose it because you did. I should tell what happens in KOTOR now. You're fucked up.
No, she told this on the show. So this
and you're telling me, like, I this is her story to tell. You can't be embarrassing Chase. She can embarrass Chase because that's his significant other. I embarrass Chase
all the time. It's pretty much my move.
Man, poor Chase.
That's what every guest says. But,
I got him.
I missed that one.
He didn't really say anything. I just wanted you to think he said something. So I said, got him, because I knew that would make you say, I missed that one.
Really?
Yeah.
I think he spoiled KOTOR while I was away.
I did not. I promised you I never would. I just like to tease it. And, so,
and it's not like I'm actually going to listen to this after the fact, so I'll never know.
Wait, so you played an MMA game knowing that they live between each other's legs.
I like kicking people in the face. Like, it's that shit's fun.
So, play Street Fighter.
Street Fighter's not on Xbox.
Yes, it is.
And Streets of Rage is free.
Street Fighter's on Xbox and it's free.
Anyway. Streets of Rage is good. I haven't played it, though.
Streets of Rage 4 is great. It is excellent. Are you still talking about your MMA experience, or are you moving on to your next game?
No, I enjoyed the game. And then I started... try to play Soul Calibur because that's on Game Pass now.
It is.
And for some reason, like, I downloaded the game, everything was fine, and then the moment I started to play the game, it was like, we have an 8 gigabyte update. I was like, fuck. Yeah. And it was like, now I don't even play no more. So I don't even know why the fuck I installed the shit. I did have some friends that were playing Call of Duty. And I don't play Call of Duty anymore. I don't really play a whole lot of Versus. But watching them play on a stream really made me want to play. And I did not realize that the new Call of Duty, like the full game, that shit is cross-platform.
Yes, yeah. It is.
I had no idea because I have not played a Call of Duty game. I haven't played the last few. So, like, I didn't even know that shit was really crossplay because, like, I was watching someone do a stream and then someone else wanted to play, but they were on Xbox. This dude was on PS4, and it was just like, yeah, send it to this place. And then they were playing the game together, and I was like, that's fucking dope. I would do that just to be able to crossplay with people.
But you know what? You said you don't really play PvP anymore, and then I was like, I didn't think so either. But then actually when I did get back into Destiny, I started playing more Crucible, and I realized I still like this. Even though, like, Call of Duty broke me from liking it, but getting back into Crucible, I really like Crucible. But you know what I don't like? This is one thing I forgot to talk about when I was talking about Destiny. And people that play Destiny, if you like this, I want someone to explain it to me, why they like it. But fuck the hell out of Gambit. Like, at first, I was like, man, this is fun because I played a couple of matches and we won or whatever. But Gambit,
I've heard it explain, like, what kind of mode it is, but I've never actually played it. I don't think I played any PvP in Destiny 2 at all.
Well, here's the thing. Well, you did with us a little bit, some Crucible, but I remember that. But Gambit is mostly PvE. You're taking out bosses and whatnot. At the very end, you spawn. They'll drop little orbs. You put the orbs in a big bank, and when you filled it all up, a giant boss will appear, and there's another team in a different area. If you kill your bosses before the other one, then you win.
But the other team, there's a portal. One person can come through and fight you, and if they kill you, they can take your motes. Or if you're Prime Evil, the big boss, they can heal it. If they kill you, it'll get some health back to it. So, but the thing is, when you invade, it's so easy. Like, I was thinking, well, it's kind of easy for me, but I think it's broken. Because here's the thing, when you invade, you see where everybody is, but they can't see you. Their names, like how you see your teammates, you see their names. They can't see you, and you've got an overshield. Like, in the Destiny statistics, my average, there's four players on each team. My average kill per invade is 3. That's average. Because I just go in there with Dome Blaze, kill at least 3 people, sometimes the entire team. Because I see where everybody is, and I'm fucking invincible almost. So,
yeah, that
it's so stupid. Because, I mean, I kill all of them, but if they come over there, yeah, they're killing half of us. Unless we happen to see where they are.
Yeah, that doesn't sound fun.
But I just play it because you play 4 and you get pinnacle gear or whatever. But I just get that out of the way. But it's really dumb, and I don't like it. I think at least one of those things should be away. Like, you should, if you have an overshield, you shouldn't be able to see where everybody is. Or if you see where everybody is, they can see where you are too. Like, it should be. I know it's 1 versus 4. But if it's 1 versus a super souped up dude that can see where you are, and it's still not evenly matched. You know what I mean?
That's accurate.
But
all right, Rashani, go. Rashani, go.
Rashani, go.
Because you're just going to keep talking about Destiny and no one else here cares.
She got nerve. So, recently, like today, I downloaded a game on Game Pass because it's free, and it came out today. It's not free, but I already paid for it. It is called Undermine, and it is a roguelike RPG type game, and it's fun. I like the humor in it. I like the characters. It reminds me of a lot of games that I have on the Switch. Like, it feels like roguelites have become a genre du jour. But I just keep falling back into the trap of playing them because I don't know. I fucking like them.
I don't think I've ever really actually played one.
You should try one, but especially if you got Game Pass. You should try Enter the Gungeon. It's free. If you
I bought Enter the Gungeon on my fucking Switch, and I just never used my Switch.
The only one I really got into is
Dead Cells.
Yeah, Dead Cells.
Love Dead Cells. Love it. Love it to pieces. Beat it once and then went to the second level, like the harder level, and haven't came close since. But I beat Paper Mario the Origami King a couple days ago.
Never played one of those either.
It's a really unique fighting style. The story is hilarious, and yet it really is touching, surprisingly so. The music is splendid, and it was just a great time. And then I've been playing a lot of Clash Royale on my iPad and on my phone.
Still?
But even more than that, because I'm not a quitter, but even more than that, it's not like I fucking pay for it, but even more than, like, seriously, bro, like, you're still smoking. I don't ask you about it still. Let an addict be an addict, bitch.
Why gotta be all like that, dog? you got, like, really defensive. All I said was still. I didn't know that was still a thing.
Yeah, it's still a thing.
Most of the people that I know that were like the people who played like Marvel Puzzle Quest and stuff like that, and they were so fucking addicted to it, it was like, yo, I gotta walk away from this shit. But you're still about that life.
Yeah, because it's free and I'm fucking good at it. Like, why would I, like, that's like saying walk away from having sex. Like, why would I do that? It's free now and I'm good at it. And
because you've broken your penis before.
I like it. Yes, I've broken that boundary, and I went to the fourth story. Like, now I am in the cosmos. I am fucking with the stars. But I am also, there's this game that I recommend to everybody if they have an Android or an iPhone, either one. It doesn't really matter. It's called Retro Bowl. and it is a version of Tecmo Bowl that is on your phone. It's not Tecmo Bowl, it's Retro Bowl, and you can play full seasons. There's a career mode, and it's really, really fucking great.
Does it do the thing that I always said that video games should do? Like Super Tecmo Bowl had the thing where, like, one day, like, your players might not feel very good, and like that has never happened in any other sports.
Yeah, game. Actually, in this game, there's moments where your players will get mad because they didn't get enough catches. Or your player will have an illegal substance in the car and get pulled over by a cop. And if you find them, then their morale drops. But if you don't find them, the whole team's morale drops because you're babying somebody. Wow. It gives you choices like that. And it starts off as a free game. I did pay, I think, 99 cents to support it.
I'm going
to
show you something. Uh-oh. I just opened Google Play. And it's right here. It's the second fucking thing right there in Google Play. You can't
fucking
really
fantastic.
See
it. It is a wonderful game. You should download it now. I think I'm on my 17th season.
Oh, it's free.
It's free, yeah. But then you can do an in-app purchase if you like it. And I did it to support them because it's a really good game.
I got like $30 in Google Rewards money. Like,
how does that work? I have Google Rewards money. And for
gift
some reason,
me shit.
Some reason, it won't let me use it in Google Play.
Send it to me. I'll figure it out. Seriously, though. But, yeah, and then let me see. What else have I been playing? Oh, I went back and started playing Puzzle Quest again on my Switch.
I miss Puzzle Quest. The original, you know, not two.
No, the first one. Yeah, the first one. And what I realize is the game is still annoying. There still runs where the computer cheats like a motherfucker.
Bruh.
But the further you go into the game and the more magic spells you unlock, like as you take the opponent's magic spells, you become a cheating bastard yourself, and then it becomes evenly fun.
Absolutely. Stampede that motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. Over and over again.
I'm a knight all day, every day.
I don't know. I think I'm a bard or a wizard or something. It doesn't really matter, but it's real.
Yep.
And I think that's it. I did play this game called Solitarica. It's like solitary, but it's a roguelike on your iPad, and it's fun too.
Okay. All right. So before we wrap this up, and I'm gonna put this question out for Rashani to answer, but I got. Well, Scott answered this in the Discord where we asked the question about what are the, like, the CDs and stuff that you purchased that you're embarrassed about.
Mm-hmm.
And the homie Mike J sent me one, and he said that he would say he has like an ABBA collection.
Okay.
Like, but he said, and you know, he's from Poland. So like yeah. he said it's Eurotrash. So he's proud to own it, but it is kind of embarrassing.
Okay.
I only know one song of ABBA's, so like I can't really say whether that's like embarrassing or not. Cuz I only know Dancing Queen. Like that's really the only shit I know.
That is an ABBA song, isn't it? Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, that's the only song I know of theirs.
I don't know how it goes, but
whenever
I think of ABBA, I immediately hear songs in the chord of the Bee Gees. Like it doesn't work any other way. Like the 70s, if it's not, first of all, fuck all y'all for saying fuck disco and getting disco out the way, because once disco became all black people, that's when it became a problem. I just want to throw that out there real quick. That's how that worked out. So I have ABBA in my head and I have the Bee Gees, and those are the only two white groups that I know that were doing disco, because all the rest of them were black folks like Gloria Gaynor, and y'all pushed them out the door to make way for nothingness. That then became hip hop. So you brought this shit on yourself.
But if it wasn't for disco, we would not have Off the Wall, which is like the greatest disco album without actually being really disco.
Yep. And people still love it. And it's disco pop. And yes, Chase, you are right back to where you were at the beginning of the show, just sitting there looking.
Well, have you guys heard of Boney M with the Rasputin?
No, but it sounds like a sex move.
Yeah. I'm gonna give you my Boney M.
With the Rasputin.
Watch when the Rasputin come, girl.
I'm Rasputin.
Rasputin.
Yeah, it's very strange, but it's
that's what my wife said.
Think of the fucking juice.
The fuck is Bunks?
But yes, a German disco group that their main song is about a Russian guy, but it's an earworm, and dude's dancing is insane. He's got a lot of energy. I'll link you in the chat later.
Okay.
You'll thank me later.
Probably not, but okay. All right, so, Rashani.
Question.
CDs that you were embarrassed to purchase. I talked about, like, buying the U-God album and stuff like that. Like, I actually own the U-God album.
Okay. All right. I may have been one of the only people I know who actually bought another Bad Creation second album.
The second album? Wow, they had one?
They did. And I bought it, and
what
it
the fuck happened? What was on the second album?
Them making fun of Crisscross a lot. Like, it was a diss record by a bunch of 8-year-olds. And they had a song on there called All You Wanna Be ABCs. And they were talking about Crisscross, and it's the worst thing ever. Also, Shaquille O'Neal's second album. A lot of bad second album choices came out of my house.
What was on that one? The second
Biological album? Didn't bother.
I didn't hate the Shaquille O'Neal albums that I had purchased.
It was a Twism era.
I didn't hate those. I know that they're not great. I know that they're not great. And like the first album was very much like, yo, this dude came into a lot of money. So he used that money to make songs with all of his favorite people. And then for some reason he thought that he could do this on his own.
All right. Let me see. What other embarrassing CDs did I 69 Boys, of course.
I ain't buy the whole thing. Fuck no.
Yeah. I believed in them in a way that they didn't believe in themselves. MC Brains.
I had Brainstorming.
Yeah.
I love the title track where he's pretending to be so deep. Like nigga, feel the fuck out of here with that shit. Your name is MC Brains. Fuck out of here.
See. What else?
I had that though.
I'm really trying to think of an embarrassing album that I purchased with no shame. And was just like, this the best. And I can't really think of any right now. But I know that there's at least one where it's like, what was on your... Oh, yeah. Ice Cube had a kid group. Did you know that? What? Ice Cube had a kid group.
Why?
I don't know. I bought their CD.
So what were they called?
Caution. K-A-U-S-I-O-N. Caution.
Wow.
And it was three boys, and they were rappers, and they were like 13 years old, and they cussed like a motherfucker.
Okay.
One of the lyrics is, I'm only 13, but already serving heat on these streets, deleting motherfuckers from the front seat, which I just thought was the hardest line in the world when I was like 16, 15.
Scott said that he bought the DMC album.
Oh man.
Yeah. And he thought it was funny because Chase had no idea what Blacked is.
Yeah, I bought you remember MC Breed?
I've heard of MC Breed.
And the DFC. In the song There Ain't No Future in Your Frontin', he said, because you know it's MC Breed, and then they say, and the DFC. I bought the DFC's album.
I thought of a new one. I bought Drowning Pool.
Wow. Like, did they have other songs other than Let the Bodies Hit the Flow?
Yeah. It's funny because I was like, what is this? I was at Walmart. Do you remember when Walmart had things where you can scan the CD and listen to a little bit? Well, it sounded like shit, right? Like the quality. So that made the song sound heavier because it was like, it sounded more raw, I guess. But when I got home, I was like, man, this is terrible.
When I got the Hollywood Undead, like the Hollywood Undead was just like, yo, what the fuck did I get myself into?
I bought JT Money's first album.
Ooh. Who that?
Yeah.
I talked on the last show that I bought the Crazy Town album just based off of Butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
And as much as I make fun of them, I went through a phase where I really liked a whole bunch of boy band stuff, but I actually did buy the O-Town album, and I bought the Five album.
The who album?
Five.
I mean, I do know somebody who bought 28 Days. Is that what their group name was? The one that Puffy put together?
Oh, that was Day 26.
Day 26.
Yeah, I didn't really watch that making a band. Like,
bought that album movie. And bought the band.
The band is still my shit. I actually use a clip from that album at the very, very end of all of the shows. Every single Scarcasm has a clip from the band album. Mm-hmm. The same way you use the DMX. I still use a very, very small piece that came off of the band album.
I like that shit. Yeah.
Yep. With the homie Young Chop. I gotta think of some more shit that like I know I have a lot. I have a whole lot that I'm just kind of like, why the fuck did I buy this? But it's just
you kind of have to look through your actual CD collection because if you look in your MP3s or your Spotify or whatnot, it's like that's curated. You have to actually go into your storage and look through. You're like, holy shit, I forgot about that.
You know, yeah. I used to have
Jimmy and the Critters, who their hit song was Roaches and Somebody Farted.
Is that the Roaches, that the song Roaches that was based off of Rumors?
Mm-hmm.
I remember that. I remember that song.
Mm-hmm. I bought his album. I also bought the album Butt Talks, which was nothing more than people farting into a microphone.
I did talk about last episode that I bought the Bloodhound Gang album.
The Me and You Ain't Nothing But Mammals, the Discovery Channel's album?
I'm sorry. I did.
He said, forget all my shit.
That was back in the MP3.com days. I love that shit. I love that song. So like, I was like, you know what? I'm buying the whole shit.
It's such a stupid song, Scar.
I know, but I liked it.
Scar. Hey,
I talked about buying the Dynamite Hack album that had the white dude version of Boys in the Hood on it. So like, I can't really, like, I, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Have you ever heard that?
Not on purpose.
Do that shit. It is the whitest version of an Eazy-E song ever.
I said not on purpose, Scar.
You should totally do that. You should totally do that.
I did buy an X-Clan album.
I bought an X-Clan album by accident.
Oh, no, that was on purpose.
I bought the X-Clan album. I was supposed to be buying the Wu-Tang Clan album. I had not heard of the Wu-Tang Clan yet, but someone told me how great 36 Chambers was. So I went in thinking Clan, and I ended up with X-Clan. And I spent my whole fucking allowance that week on the X-Clan album. And that ended up being, it was an eye-opening experience.
I also bought Dragon's first album. Yeah, soak that one in, fellas. I did that.
No, I've heard that one before.
I believed in Dragon.
I heard that one. I think Kim said the same thing, right?
The song with him and Eve just was so great. I want to talk about bitch.
Apparently, there is a Rough Riders miniseries. I've seen stuff on YouTube about it, but apparently it came on BET about the Rough Riders. And I was like, who decided to make this documentary now?
Yeah, so what happened was I heard Eve's album.
Shit.
And I liked Dragon so much in her album that I thought he'd be good in his own album, and it wasn't.
There's this song.
That's like buying all of the albums from the motherfuckers in the Dipset. Like,
yeah. Yeah. Freaky Zeke.
I just... you know what? It just hit me. I'm really embarrassed to say this, but it just made me think of like people who were in like these groups and you thought that they would be better. But then you buy the album and you're like, man, what the fuck is this shit? I bought the Rampage album.
The last Boy Scout?
Nigga.
Wait. You bought the last Boy Scouts album?
I bought it.
The one with Take It to the Streets?
I bought it.
Me too.
whatever happened to Lord Have Mercy? I really like that dude.
Oh God,
he just had a voice. It wasn't really for rap, but he just sounded like he could voice a character in God of War. Like he just had that voice, and like I was, you know, me with my voice, I'm just kind of like, man, I want one of those.
You know, I was the guy who. My brother was never like he was. Wherever we were, I was not allowed to have the ox.
Yeah,
I wasn't allowed to have the ox. I wasn't allowed to have control of the CDs. He would literally unhook the face of the radio, so I couldn't put a CD. And we just ride in silence because I'd be like, "Trust me."
Nigga, you bought Rampage.
Oh God, my credibility was shot when I tried to tell him about the power of Chris Gaines.
Wow.
Like, yo, let me tell you, it's not like other country singers. Chris Gaines is darker.
Chris Gaines is just Garth Brooks' alter ego.
I bought Tyrese's album when he was Black Tie.
Nah, I ain't go that far. I did not go that far. I bought
for Nisha for our 2 month anniversary.
Fuck no.
Oh God, I bought Black Tie.
Fuck no. Like I have very, very horrible taste. I could not do that to myself.
Hey, there's a song that would come on the radio a lot, and I've kind of looked for it. I'm not even sure if it's good. I just was like, what the fuck is that?
Tell us about it. We got you.
And it was like, I just remember the beat was pretty simple, but it had this, I don't think it's a guitar, but it was some sort of stringed instrument that they were sampling, but it was like, or whatnot. It was basically the thing, but,
Special Delivery?
Maybe.
Was it a rap song?
Yeah.
Okay.
That part totally made me that, like what you just did made me think of Special Delivery.
Yeah.
I'll look that up after the show.
See if, yeah. And then Lil Wayne just made a song with basically the same beat. He made a song on his last album with the exact same beat.
Oh. Cool. But yeah. It's crazy, like, Rashani, you really came out there on the embarrassing albums. You were, like, firing them one after another.
I've lived an eventful life. I have. I am the dude who discusses getting his ass whooped over a Shaquille O'Neal I Know I Got Skills t-shirt. Because I didn't know the dude knew black belt. Didn't know he knew karate. Till he stole my shirt, and I tried to get it back 4 times. I got my ass whooped 4 times. And then finally, he took off the shirt to wipe the sweat off his face, and one of my brother ran up and grabbed the shirt, and we ran in the house and locked the door. I literally got my ass whooped up the block. Oh, God. I was the kid who in college was sitting in a room by himself listening to Uninvited by Alanis Morissette because I also bought the City of Angels soundtrack.
Oh, wow.
And thought I was deep.
Did you buy Vanilla Sky also?
No, but I did buy the Rent soundtrack in college, too.
The Rent soundtrack. I don't know anything about the Rent. Except for that's how I know how many minutes are in a year.
I like, think the Vanilla Sky soundtrack. Okay.
Mm-mm. That movie had like great potential and then ended up being like, what the fuck is this? Kind of like What Dreams May Come. Like What Dreams May Come had so much potential and then it was just like, man, what the fuck is this?
Oh, I bought One Monkey Don't Stop No Show.
Wow. I stopped buying Goody Mob albums when he left.
I believed in them.
Did you know that that Happy was originally for CeeLo?
I believe.
And there is a CeeLo version that was recorded, and basically what was released as Happy was basically Pharrell doing his CeeLo impression as the reference track, but the company was like, we're not signing off on you doing a fucking song for Despicable Me. Get the fuck out of here with that shit. And so he basically cleaned up the reference track and then put out Happy, and it became the biggest fucking song ever. But yeah, apparently there is a full on CeeLo Green version of Happy available.
I believe it. I have nothing more to say tonight.
CeeLo Green, there's probably a lot of people that don't know that Forget You is actually Fuck You.
Black folks know.
We know. That's kind of like that Justin Bieber song, Love Yourself, is really Go Fuck Yourself. Go Fuck Yourself. Yeah. It's totally Go Fuck Yourself.
That was such a great diss song, though. For a white pop star, my mom, what was the line? He was like, my mom pretends to like you or something like that. Like, yo, that was a great song.
Yep. Sorry. All right. I think it's time to wrap this thing up.
That's what she said.
Wow. There's this video that I saw the other day, and I think if you care about this subject, you should watch this. Do you know about the game Sekiro or whatever, the ninja game?
Twice. Yeah.
Someone modded that game, and it's a one-on-one sword fight with CJ and Big Smoke.
I saw that.
That shit was dope to me. There was a shortened version.
That's where I saw it. There was
a shortened version, and then there's a much longer version where Smoke basically gets his revenge and kills CJ. Spoiler alert.
So you just spoiling shit left and right.
I mean, I think it's funny to say spoiler alert after the spoiler. I think it's kind of funny. Except for certain things, like, you know, certain things I'm not going to spoil. But that, yeah. But there's a longer version, and that was just really kind of dope, and I like that. But I think that's it. Rashani, you want to say what you need to the people?
So, single simulcast, Sentence Solace, Dream Team, 20 Minutes, Unburdened, Storytellers, Hindsight. I feel like there's one more. Fuck with us. We've been here for a long time. We're only getting better. Consistently good. We know what we are. Y'all should find out and get on board. By the way, the slogan for Consistently Good, Scar, have you heard the slogan yet?
No.
Oh, man. The slogan for Consistently Good is quite simply, goddamn, goddamn, goddamn. You can really try it out. It's awesome.
Instead of damn, damn, damn.
It's already been taken, but goddamn, goddamn, goddamn. You try our food, you'll understand. Next show comes out on Sunday. Next show comes out on Tuesday. Thanks for having me on. I really do appreciate it. I guess the only thing that's left to say is, sheesh. Play me out, Scar. Oots, 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 oots. Do you think you are?
He's absolutely not going to stop. So while he's still going, thank you everybody that checks us out. We'll be back next week with more August.
Weekends were made for fun.
So Blue and Elaine are coming next week. For the homie Chase.
Hold on, one more thing.
Fucking Rashani. I'm Scarfinger. This is Scarcasm. We're out of here. Peace out to the Warriors.
I forgot.
What?
Oot, 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 oot.
I'm making that face, like, people can't see this, but I'm making the face when Cuba Gooding had the gun to his face. Scarcasm. 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 Scarcasm.
I like that shit, yeah, boy. Yeah, I'm telling you, Woe. I'm telling. All right, I ain't gonna talk.
Somewhere out there, there are people who thought Belly was a good soundtrack.
Okay, Belly was not a good soundtrack, like not at all. Like it doesn't even come close. It's not. It doesn't even rank. It like well, there's only two of like the best soundtracks in like these like hood movies. Like there's only two answers, right?
Yeah.
Like if you talk about which one is the best, if you use either one of these answers, you're good.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, Above the Rim and Waiting to Exhale. Like that's it. Like there's no.
Is Waiting to Exhale a hood movie though?
I think so. I'm gonna call it
a Tyler movie.
Kind of, but like I think so. But when we talk about movie soundtracks, I think those are the top. Like there was,
I think you gotta include Boys in the Hood in there.
I don't love Boys in the Hood. You know what? I like Juice more than Boys in the Hood when it comes to soundtracks.
I gotta look at the Juice soundtrack. I'm gonna look at it right now.
That shit got No The Ledge on it, bro.
It's we're not gonna do it just for one song, bro.
It got No The Ledge. It's kind of like it was written as Shootouts. Like you can't mention like Shootouts, nigga. Like what are we talking about?
Never heard it before.
You never heard Shootouts on It Was Written, Nas?
I don't listen to Nas. Remember?
Yeah, but like
Uptown
Shootouts. Anthem. Shootouts was produced by Dr. Dre.
Oh, I remember this song. Doom, 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 doom.
Yes,
we gonna break. We gon' whatever. Yeah, that song. And then No The Ledge. And then Is It Good? You Sex, Money, and Murder was a bop, too. No Respect, Do. Okay, so You Want to Be a Gangster. Okay, I know that one. Don't Be Afraid, the rape song.
Yes.
And then after that, no. There's six songs.
Yeah, six? Like, that's six.
Okay, yo. I gotta go because I've been with y'all instead of being with my wife for, like, the last 2 hours, and so I'm sure that I forgot to do something, probably like cook dinner.
I mean, hanging out with me is kind of the same as if I don't have a vagina.
Don't you, though? It's like a flashlight, right? It's a flashlight?
Yeah, I got one of those.
Yeah. Did you know that he has a pocket pussy, Chase?
Yes.
Yeah, he's got a flashlight.
I don't.
It's on his OnlyFans page. Do you have the password, Chase? I don't.
Doesn't everybody have a vagina if they have a mouth?
That is true. It's just a mouth, Scar.
I hate you both. Bye. Bye, niggas. Bye, niggas.
Bye.
All right. What were we just talking about?
Vaginas on your face.